Harlem, man.
Harlem, Harlem.
I be in Harlem, man.
I be in Harlem, man.
We the only thing moving, man.
Only thing moving,
deep
man.
In the game,
yup.
Up.
Yup.
40th.
40th.
Harlem.
Harlem.
Rat.
Well now, children. Tonight, old Uncle Tom going to tell you the real true story.
The South Central Cartel has signed up as Def Jam's newest West Coast rap act.
When we done this new album, Russell Simmons let us go in the studio and do exactly what we wanted to do.
The G's on the Move video, a shootout broke out at the video where five people got shot and one person deceased. He called me pissed, pissed. I mean, when I say pissed, this was the start of me and his
Riff.
Bad relationship.
You and Russell Simmons.
Right. Uh-huh. First of all, before all of this occurred, we received documentation from, at the time, was Havoc and Prodigy, right? Saying that we stole their name. But remember, me and Prodigy, and that's been Havoc and Prodigy since like 87, 88. And two little bitty young dudes, probably maybe that tall, right, run up on me because I got on a link chain and had a big Havoc on it.
Because that's the one he spoke about in his book, I believe.
Right, and then talking about something, we got shook. And that's nigga, there ain't no motherfucking group in the history of rap and nigga ever shook SEC.
Outside of LA, what were some of SEC's biggest markets?
Streets everywhere.
Okay, so pretty much
streets.
Yeah.
We wasn't a radio type of friendly group.
No, not at all.
They didn't, even when Gangsta Love came out, right?
The home of true gangsters, down for all when approached by a stranger. We
actually used the same beat from Gangsta Love on one of his big songs.
Little girl named Corinne. Some say the blacker the better, the sweeter the juice. I say the darker the flesh and the deeper the roots.
Okay, I'm tripping. Tell me where. Okay, there it is. Okay, that's the one with Spice One. Give it to
Ice-T and MC8, okay. Compton Most Wanted.
Okay.
This is your commander in chief of your West Coast operation, Havoc the Mouthpiece. My orders are to assemble a team of six of the West Coast dopest rappers. I have chosen Prodigy, Havoc the Rhyme Son, Spice Motherfucking One, Tupac, 8 from Compton Most Wanted, and Ice-T. So let the gangster team begin.
The purpose of that song, the original song was called, West Coast Massacre.
Okay.
That's why Pac say you can't fuck with the West Coast Massacre. Because when I hollered at Pac about getting on the song, because me and Pac had already been hanging out already. We was kind of cool, you know what I mean? We did an interview together with Sherry Carter at the Marriott at another Jack the Rapper when Pac called me in on the interview when he was getting interviewed by Sherry Carter. And that's when I pulled out the SEC poster that he was on that album. He was always cool with me, man.
And yeah, give me a good Pac story.
Wow.
Good Pac story.
I took Pac to the Spice One video, Trigger Gas No Heart.
A nigga got no heart. A nigga got no heart.
He was leaving the studio and Spice had the last verse, so I was going to pick Spice up. And I took him to the video and found out that he didn't know about it and he was looking for the Hughes brothers, and that's when
the Hughes brothers situation.
So met the motherfuckers at the Spice One video for Trigger Got No Heart, and as sure as Spice One was singing how the Trigger had no heart, Tupac has no heart. What's that say? Heartless. And I beat the motherfuckers down. Sock his punk ass and start throwing things like I'm blue in the box. The partner he had with him start begging me to stop beating him up, but I kept beating his punk ass up. Then, instead of fighting me like a G, he ran. Now, I can't help it if some niggas that was on the scene beat his ass for running. That was something separate, you understand me? And I can't help it if they were screaming thug life as they did it.
You know, we riding around for a minute, then he pull out a newspaper. And it said that Tupac comes to the set of the movie drunk and high and he can't remember his lines. And that he got fired from the set. And he didn't know that until he read the paper. So he was mad as fuck. He didn't even know they fired him until he read the paper.
And so it was pretty much my fault for taking it.
Wait, so you drove Pac to the Spice One where he had the whole Hughes brothers?
We was at Larrabee Studio in Santa Monica.
Hey, that's some, that's there. Yeah, you got some exclusive shit right there.
We was at Larry's studio on Santa Monica. Ice, Pac had just did it first. Ice-T was actually in the booth when I said, I'm finna go get Spice, because 8 was on his way, and he was shooting the video of Straight Up Menace the next day.
Wake your punk ass up for the 93 shot. MC 8's in the motherfucking house. Yeah. And it ain't nothing but a Compton thing, y'all.
The next day, where I went to after one brother was all beat up and all of that, and I asked him, why you leave your brother? Why you run and leave your brother?
You asked
me? Yeah.
That's what's up.
Yeah. If me and my brother was in a fight, right, and a bunch of dudes come around here right now, and then one of us is going to run and go nowhere. Mm-hmm. We're going to get back to back, and we're going to take our ass whooping together.
Yeah.
Period. Period. I don't give a period. Period. No disrespect to how that happened, but I'm saying what me and my brother would have done.